Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome everybody to Amazed by the Qur'an, a series in which I like talking to you about what I find amazing about the Qur'an. One of the fascinations that I've had in this series, of course, as you've noticed, is ayat that are very similar to each other, and we're going to continue along that track. Two ayat that I'm going to compare similar expressions from, one belonging to Surah Hud, the 11th surah, and the other belonging to Surah Al-Ankabut, the 29th surah, both talking about the great prophet Lut alayhi salam, or Lot as he's called in the Bible. Only the first expression is what I'm going to compare in these two ayat. وَلَمَّا جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا لُوتًا سِيءَ بِهِمْ. When our messengers finally came to Lut, he felt terrible because of them. See Abihim. He found their presence terrible. Same ayah repeats itself in Ankabut. وَلَمَّا أَن جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا لُوطًا سِي أَبِهِمْ. There's an additional an here. The previous was وَلَمَّا جَاءَتْ. This one is وَلَمَّا أَن جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا لُوطًا سِي أَبِهِمْ. And the translation, even though in regular translations is identical, the purpose of an is actually to add even more long period or anticipation or eventuality. So eventually, finally, after the longest wait, when the angels finally arrived to Lut, he felt terrible because of their presence. So there's this longer duration and kind of this longer anticipation of when is the help of Allah coming. Because Lut was frustrated, when will the help of Allah come? But the way in which it came in the form of good-looking men made him even more upset. Right? But the idea of that prolonging is mentioned in Ankabut, not mentioned in Hud. This is actually something that I want to talk to you about, and you'll be surprised. The subject today is not Lut at all. The subject isn't Lut at all. The subject is our own Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The thing to understand here is that the Quran tells the Prophet alaihi wasallam stories of previous messengers to encourage him and to help him see his mission through their eyes. Their legacies become his legacy. Their words become his words. That's why they're in the Quran. Understand that in the Meccan experience, when the Prophet is speaking, right, he's speaking the Quran. There's no book in front of him. There's no paper in front of him, right? And when he's talking about these prophets' legacies, people don't separate those legacies from him because they're coming out of his mouth. He doesn't separate himself from them. They're all one body of people. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم. And he identifies himself with the missions of these great prophets. Now, having said that, Surah Hud is earlier in his mission. And earlier in his mission, Allah says, mentioning the story of Lut, you know, sometimes what Allah brings as help is not something you'll find pleasing. But then what happens in Ankabut? Why this longer anticipation? You know why? Because the entire Surah Al-Ankabut, it began, Alif Lam Mim, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسَ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Surah Al-Ankabut began when the Muslims were starting to get tortured. Things were getting really bad. Khabbab bin Arat, a companion, was dragged onto burning coal, made to lie down on it shirtless, and they stood on him. They melted the skin off of his back. And he went in that state to the Prophet ﷺ and said, what have we done wrong that this should happen to us? Why isn't the help of Allah coming? And then these ayat came down. And so when Surah Luqman came down, or Surah Al-Ankabut came down, the first ayat are about patience to the believers. And they're being told, do you think that you're just going to enter heaven without being tested? People that came before you were tested too. وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Then he starts talking about Nuh. No accident. He starts talking about Noah. Why? Because Nuh alayhi salam, centuries. Centuries. He had to be patient. And then the help to Nuh alayhi salam came in by water. Then he talks about Ibrahim, who had to take on his own people. And then he talks about Ibrahim, and Ibrahim was saved from a fire. Like Nuh was saved from water, Ibrahim was saved from fire. Then after Nuh, he talks about Lut, and he says about Lut, Inni muhajirun ila rabbi sayahdeen. I'm making migration to my master soon, he will guide me. Through Lut, the Prophet is being told, you're going to migrate too soon. Nuh had to leave his people. Abraham had to leave his people. Lot actually spelled out, I am making migration. Ankabut is almost right before the migration of the Prophet himself. He's being told in code, through other prophetic legacies, that he's going to have to migrate. Now in that case, when is the commandment coming? When can we finally get out of here? The anticipation is so much higher that when the story of Lut is being talked about, eventually, when finally, in the end, our messengers came, the intensity of the wait is highlighted more in this surah, because the entire surah is about waiting for relief from Allah to come. That's the subject of the surah. And through just that little an, the Prophet ﷺ is being given relief. It will come. It will come. And it will come in unexpected ways. But you just watch. You just wait. SubhanAllah. So awesome. So yes, it is the story of Lut alayhi salam in both cases. But through the story, what the Prophet is being told, that is what I find amazing in this passage. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.